study from Switzerland, and today I wanted to do something a little bit different, more of a discussion or philosophy kind of video regarding custom knives. You see the custom knives out of my collection in the middle of the screen, and then towards the edges are like the fringe companies or fringe knives that some people consider more in the custom realm, some consider them outside of the custom realm. And I just wanted to give my two cents to it, show off some of the knives that I got here, and also wanted to hear what you think, what for you defines a custom knives, if you are interested in them, or if you don't think that there is more value in a custom knives considering all the great quality production folders that we got at the moment, and all the things that you now can get in a production folder that were completely unheard of a couple of years ago in terms of materials, in terms of finishing, and also mechanisms and innovation. And it's very possible that you hear a little bit of rain noise because it's heavily raining here in Switzerland at the moment. But I just wanted to get this video done today because this is a topic that I was thinking about quite a bit, especially because I amassed some of the customs that I really wanted on the channel or in my collection in the last couple of years, and I just wanted to share with you what my passion for the custom knives is, what I look for in a custom knife, and what the drawbacks and negative aspects of this market are as well. And you also can see when you take a look at the selection of custom knives that I have here, it's quite a bit different from most people that collect custom knives, in my opinion. You see a lot of a little bit out there designers that you don't see that often in the US, at least. You have a lot of French designers here with Guy Pogetti, Rémi Laviale, and other European designers like Simon Strickers here at the top. Some, in my opinion, very underappreciated US designers like Brad Zinker, we have three times here. We have something from Australia here. We have Dirk Pinkerton, a custom here, and here Casey Gray. So it's a little bit the more underappreciated, slightly overlooked makers that I have, but I also have something that is very high in demand at the moment, and that is the Roosevelt here by Ozzie Machine Company. And I had until earlier today also a Skiff Made Blades Drifter that you may have seen on my Instagram and my channel, which has been sold, but only to fund my own build, because that one I acquired on the secondary market, and my build is coming up in February, so I actually decided to sell that to fund my own commissioned build. So that would also certainly be a part of my custom collection, and I'm not going to sell that one as far as I foresee. So the things that we're gonna talk about first is the knives on the edges of this little frame I put up for you. That are, for example, here, Shirogorov knife. This is a Neon Zero. You certainly have seen that on my channel if you follow for any length of time. One of my favorite knives, especially favorite EDC knives. And some people considering Shirogorov knives custom. Shirogorov knives is a little bit of a special thing because they got like tiers. They have the regular one, then they have the custom division, and then they have the full customs by Sergei Shirogorov. The regular production versions of the Shirogorovs are still going for quite high amounts of dollars. There is the custom divisions are even higher, and the full customs are multiple thousands of dollars. Even the custom divisions sometimes can go very, very high up into the thousands of dollars. So the regular kind of Shirogorovs that you can buy are, in my opinion and most people's opinion, not considered custom, but very high-end production knives, and they certainly have a lot of features that you previously only saw in custom knives. They have very, very high-end machining, very great CNC work, very clean and very well-made overall designs, and great materials here, for example, M390, titanium, 3D milled pocket clip, hidden hardware construction. So all of the things that you previously saw on more custom knives, you can get that here on these higher end production knives. But I think most people would consider the regular kind of Shirogorov knives as high-end production knives and not customs, and I think in that realm these are pretty much at the top tier of what you can expect. Same thing would be for Chris Reeve knives, but I think Chris Reeves are even more in the production realm. I know a lot of people would consider Chris Reeve knives custom knives more so in the Shirogorovs, for example, because they got that tiered system. That was the Neon. Here we have the F95NL, just a more iconic and older overall design and a larger one. Then to the other side, you have another Russian company that is a little bit harder to define, in my opinion. This is the Cheburkov Strish. This is the smaller Strish, an older model from them that you can thumb open and you can also front flip, which a lot of people don't know. But these are also made by a bunch of people, so not just one maker. There is a guy called Alexander Cheburkov, which is the founder and owner and main maker of these knives, but there are a bunch of people in a factory working on these Cheburkov knives, but I would consider them more in the realms of custom knives than a full production Shirogorov here. Not just because you have a lot of different options to choose from and that they are a much, much smaller overall shop and they put out much less knives over the years, but also because there seems to be quite a bit more handwork involved. There are quite a bit of differences and you can actually tell a little bit which guys have been working on your particular build here. And for me, these really border on custom knives. I would call this mid-tech, even though I don't really like that term, just because of the way that these are made. And there you see how I kind of define custom knives. Custom knives are not primarily for me knives that you can specifically configure how you want them, but that is certainly a part for most people, so that you can commission a build with different materials and different things done to a knife. That is something that I really appreciate. But the main thing about a custom knife for me is that only one person or a very small group of people are working on the knife. So that means that quality control and the control over the finished product is much, much higher than if you have a bunch of people in a factory working on multiple models. So a custom knife for me is a knife maker or a knife conglomerate of people that are building low quantity knives in a slow process using more handwork, hand tools, even though maybe they use CNC. I think CNC machine custom knives are still custom knives because there is a lot of work involved and not a lot of people are touching those knives on an assembly line or something like that. So low output, high quality control, few people involved, and customization options are some of the main features of a custom knife. Of course, together with exotic materials, amazing fit and finish, and so on and so on. Also, special, unique mechanisms and things like that as well. But in my opinion, Cheburkov knives are more custom than a regular full-on production Shirogorov knife, and I think you can appreciate that by looking at the knives I showed you so far. But I wouldn't consider them full-on custom because there are a bunch of people involved still in building these knives. Another Cheburkov to show you is the Toucan, one of their more iconic and unique models. This one was the first featuring micarta inlays. And still an absolutely nice knife. And this was actually built by the main guy who builds the knife there at Cheburkov Knives. So very, very cool knife, M390 blade. And these are really well-made Russian pieces here by Cheburkov. This was built in 2017. So now that we have those out of the way, another thing that some people would consider creeping into the custom world are Rockstead knives. This is my Rockstead Coup. Amazing, amazing knife. Absolute favorite Rockstead ever built for me personally. This is how I imagine a perfect Rockstead for me. Love the size, love the DLC polished finish. All the Rockstead knives that I want would have this finish because it's so iconic for Rockstead, that polished DLC finish over the YXR7 carbon steel that they use on their less expensive blades. And then that clamshell Ergal aluminum finish here and handle construction with, of course, the super cool ray skin inserts here on both sides. So absolutely iconic knife design. Unfortunately, this particular model, the Ku, is actually discontinued. This is like a smaller Shin for those people who don't know the Ku model. But these knives have amazing fit and finish, absolutely unique kind of finishing options, especially the mirror polish DLC here. Very, very special blade grinds with this zero grind here. On this particular model, they use special materials like the ray skin inserts, and they do a lot of things very uniquely that you can't get from any other maker in the same vein of things. So that would all check some of the boxes of what I mentioned before in terms of custom knives, but some things are not the case. These are made in a factory by a larger amount of people, and this is a company that defines themselves as very, very high-end production knives. And I think these really do not tick the boxes for me for a custom knife. I really appreciate them for what they are. In prices, they are certainly more expensive than some custom knives, that's for sure. But in the way that they are produced, I would think that Rockstead knives do not go into custom knives, even though they are certainly also better in fit and finish and the quality than some custom knives, because that is also a thing that people need to understand before getting into the custom knife market. Just because it's a custom knife and made by one guy, it does absolutely not mean that it has superior quality to all the production knives out there, because people can make mistakes, and if it's a new maker that still is learning, because all these custom knife makers are learning more and more with every knife that they make, and the first couple of knives will be the first and maybe have a unique design and everything, but they will tweak the model over time, and the later models will be better than the first iterations that they have released. A very popular and recent example for that are the American Blade Works knives. That is a guy that came out with his custom knife shop, the American Blade Works knives. I also reviewed one of them, and he now is in a very short time at iteration 4 or 5 of his model 1, and every model was better than the first one. And that shows you that because it's just one guy making it, also the improvement from each model to the next can run much, much faster than if you had a larger amount of people working on the knives and a whole production system to adapt to that new upgraded production spectrum, or the adjustments that you have made to each particular knife. So absolutely love the Rockstead, but in my opinion, not a custom knife, even though superior in quality and craftsmanship over some custom knives for sure. So now we are left with knives that I believe most people would consider custom pieces, and they also are for me certainly custom knives. First off, we have fixed blades, which would certainly be for most people the least expensive way to get into a custom knife. This is a subtle warning from Dirk Pinkerton in a Damascus blade from Vegas Forge, Matrix Damascus, and a carbon fiber handle. Small neck knife or small EDC fixed blade Wharncliffe, super extremely thin grind, hollow grind, and also the treatment and the edges and the grinds are something that is very uniquely amazing on a lot of custom knives, and most of the time really exceed what you can expect from a production knife. So that is certainly also an area where I think custom knives as a whole in general do deliver more value and more expertise. But a custom fixed blade is certainly a great way to get into the custom knife, to see if you like the process of acquiring a custom knife in terms of dealing with a maker who sometimes is not a great communicator and is very hard to get back to, and it's very hard to communicate what you actually want from the maker, because that's also a thing. When you're buying custom knives, you're dealing with one person or maybe two guys that work the shop, and they do everything, and sometimes they can get overwhelmed, and it's not like you're buying a pre-finished product. most of the time. So there can be adjustments made, and it's sometimes hard to communicate that with a custom maker. Fortunately, with the knives I have here, I was always very pleasantly surprised by the conduct of the makers, by how open they were to communicate over changes of their existing designs, even adjusting something or doing something they haven't even done before, which is always a risk for a maker, of course. But that's just something that you have to know if you're up to that, if you want to be a little bit more involved with the knife that you want, or if you just want to buy something off the shelf. If you're content with that, it's probably not the best thing to go into the custom knife world, because if you go there, you normally are more involved with your knife, with the maker, and if everything goes well, you can actually form a quite a nice bond with the maker, even become friends, and really become invested in their business and their well-being. So this one is from Dirk Pinkerton, a maker which I absolutely love. He does great work in the production knife world, does great collaborations and everything, but I certainly wanted to have something custom from him just because I really like it. Wharncliffe's his overall design language, and he's also a great guy to talk to and very responsive on his Instagram channel. And I really like to reward people that do a great job in communicating and putting their ideas out there and just in designing some great pieces. And I think that's also the great thing about these production collaborations of custom knife makers. You get to know a design without spending hundreds of dollars, and you get to know a designer and a design language. And so I think that's also a big benefit for these custom makers in doing the production knife models. Also, of course, getting their designs in more hands and more people appreciating their great designs. So this is the fixed blade custom knives, and all the others, of course, are folders. And here there are different kind of tiers or different kind of processes for making knives. So here we have a more modern example. The Drifter would have been even better. So there is a lot of CNC machining, computer science involved in building these knives, but also a lot of handwork. For example, here this hand rub satin blade, and the materials that are used here are also pretty high end. There is a lot of customization done, especially on this particular model, that is unique to my knife, or has been unique to my knife. For example, the blade shape has actually been modified to my liking to be a little bit more stabbier, not as belly friendly or as belly oriented as all the rotoids that have been built before it. So it's actually called the Stabby Grind. And you also have seen that the newer models also have a swetch, which was also introduced by a customer who actually requested that. Then, of course, the materials used here, the crosscut carbon fiber, the zirconium pivot screw, the black screws in the back, zirconium backspacer and clip, and the heavy blasted titanium lock face have all been specified by me, but from an area of things that were provided to me by the maker. So I couldn't just go out there and order something very outlandish. I maybe could have, because the guy that runs Oz Machine Company actually is very, very communicative, very, very open to modifying his designs within reason and working with a lot of different models, a lot of different materials. But it certainly was inside of a certain confinement. Then, of course, what he also did for me, I don't know if you have seen that, he engraved my initials into the frame there. And that is certainly something I really love, because this really is now my particular knife. I could really influence quite a bit on this build here. Had all the things I wanted, I could choose that. But I realized everything that I wanted in the particular model that this maker was building. And of course, a thing you have to keep in mind with custom knives is there is always quite a bit of a wait time, especially if you're going into a maker that is high in demand. Because, for example, these Oz Machine Company Rosewoods at the moment cannot be ordered. He has his books closed, but he will be reopening his books in the beginning of 2021. And then you just have to jump on it, put the money aside, and when your number comes up, you have to work with him on the particular details and get your knife done as you like it. So That is certainly a very different experience from buying something from a store or from a website. In terms of custom knives, you really have to wait for a lot of these makers to get your own build going, but then you get the benefit of modifying it to your liking, more or less options available to you depending on the maker. So that is really was really cool. Also, he is also a great example for a maker that is great to talk to, great to work with, very open, and everything I said before. So highly recommend to get something from OZ Machine Company, and the Roosevelt is also an absolutely amazing design. But you could also say it's a pretty basic design, and there are a bunch of production knives that would perform the same way. And that also offer great steels, great lockup, great action, and everything. And that is certainly true. But if you go for a custom knife, you also are looking for something different than just a great functional tool that's also looking great and has great materials. You're looking for some exclusivity. You're looking for that particular soul of a knife that most production knives are really missing. That's something that's very hard to describe and can only be experienced, in my opinion, the thing with the soul, because I held so many very well machined, very well spec'd out models, also great designs, good looking, great ergonomics and everything, but it just didn't click with me. I think most knife guys have felt that in theory it's a perfect knife, it fits my hand great, everything works perfectly, but it just doesn't do it for me because there is something missing that's very hard to put the finger on it. And in custom knives, I also experienced that for something, but because of different reasons. But I think all these custom knives that are built by by a few people, really have something more to it, a soul, something that you really feel that a guy thought very long and hard about every little detail on this knife, and that really gives something else to the knife and makes it worth it for me. Not on every knife, not every knife for every purpose, but from time to time, I really like to go with a custom knife to get that very special experience. Then there are also pretty inexpensive knives, and this is also a good knife to show you that the quality of custom knives doesn't always mean it's super superior to everything else. So if you take a closer look at this one here, this is a Shaper's Build slip joint. You can see there are some gaps. There is not everything fitted very perfectly. Here you have liners that are not fitted properly. The grinds are not very symmetrical. And the finishing is not very refined. This was also a very inexpensive custom knife, and I just like the design, and I still like it very much because it's also a very nice Z-finite steel. And he also said that this knife was made to be a very inexpensive custom knife, and for that reason, he also didn't put hours and hours and hours and time in it to perfect the little intricacies of fit and finish, and you can certainly see that. But I knew what I was getting when I ordered this knife, and I liked the design, and I wanted to support that maker from Australia that is also making amazing kitchen knives. You have to check him out on Instagram there. But this certainly shows you that just because it's a custom knife, it doesn't always mean it has absolute perfect fit and finish and is better than any production knife out there. Just something to keep in mind. Still love the knife, very, very good knife. Also went to the washer once and had absolutely no damage whatsoever. So overall, a great little slip joint, but fit and finish wise, there are certainly better production knives out there that would blow this out of the water in that particular regard. But I love it for what it is, for the thought that went into it, and for the interactions that I had with that particular maker. And that is also something that I never really understand until I have gotten into the custom knife thing. And I have a very special or good relationship, for example, with Mr. Brad Zinker, which is a designer that I always liked his collaboration pieces. with Booker Plus and some other makers, and I could never imagine having a own Radzinker knife until I realized that his custom knives are actually priced very reasonably, and that he has some new models that are very attractive to me. And then I just wrote Mr. Zinker, and he was very forthcoming, very helpful, showing me different materials that he worked with, different models, size comparisons, and so on, shows me videos and everything. And it was an absolutely super pleasant way in getting a knife from him, and that's why you see three of them on the table. I really love to support that maker. He always made sure that everything was the way I wanted it to be. He went through quite a bit of hassle with customs and shipping twice on both of my orders. There was a lot of things going wrong with the post office, and every time he came through, made sure that I got the knife, even if it meant for him to lose some money on that build, paying for shipping twice, shipping it to different guys, talking with people at the custom and everything. So an absolute great maker that really understands customer service, and that is why I absolutely love to support Brad Zinker. And I think his work in general is highly underappreciated. All the fit and finish touches that he does on these knives are so well executed. He has very, very sleek and slender, gentlemanly knife designs, great grinds overall, perfect pocket clips, and he just really builds the knife that I am looking for. Also here on these Urban Trapper Arcs, with this absolutely gorgeous stack that he built into the handles, absolutely gorgeous, very, very smooth and refined action. And these really feel like handmade masterpieces. These really feel like high-end jewelry items that also are knives. And that's really what I'm looking for in these custom knives. And also, I never experienced anything like these Zinker knives. They just feel so different and so refined and thought through and really custom. It's very hard to put it into words, but the quality that you experience when you're holding one of these Urban Trapper Arcs, for example, is just so different from any production knife that you ever held. It's very, very hard to put into words, but that's really the experience I absolutely loved with these Brad Zinker knives and most of my custom folders that I had. But I think this custom knife world really is not for everybody, because you really have to be looking for this special experience, special cutting experience, special experience with the action to appreciate it. You have to be an aficionado for knives. You have to be looking for something else than just a great tool to be doing your cutting work with. So this really is for a very select number of people that are willing to spend the money and that can appreciate or find a value in this more laborious way of building these knives, because you can probably build all of these knives with more machines, make more of them, make them faster, and even maybe by securing the quality control. But you lose the special magic sauce of custom knives if you would be doing that. This is the newest acquisition here. This is a Remy Lavial Ultrafort front flipper from a very, very good French custom maker, Remy Lavial. Absolutely gorgeous overall design. Fit and finish here is absolute perfection. The materials that he chose doesn't have any kind of voids in the carbon fiber. And he did everything I requested for him. Also here, it was quite a big wait until I got what I wanted, but it was so worth it, because everything you could specify here on this knife makes it very special. The combination of everything is really what I wanted. I certainly wanted a clip, which my previous one didn't have. And everything came together very well on this particular build. Also, he is a maker that is very responsive, not as open to modifying his designs as, for example, OZ Machine Company, but still a great maker to communicate with, very forthcoming to get back to you and everything. and just overall a great experience and an absolutely great maker. Then we have here something even a little bit more special. This is a part-time smaller maker that is very limited in numbers. This is a Siemens Strickers Tour model. It's also a video on this knife on my channel, and this is even a little bit more in terms of exclusivity and specialness because most people haven't even heard of him, but he actually is making some very, very cool knife models. And I had another knife from him, and these knives are in the people who know him in very high demand. And this one I got actually in the in a lottery. The only lottery I ever won is the lottery to buy this Siemens Strickers Tour. And if you look at it from afar, it looks like a very generic kind of flipper knife, but as with most custom knives, the special things are in the details, the finishing options, the special things they try to do with the knives. Like for example, here we have a completely tapered handle, which you don't see very often on production knives. Amazing, amazing details, super well done grind, which is a strong suit of most custom knife makers. Very good ergonomics overall, and just a really interesting design. And also, these Siemens Stricker knives are crazy inexpensive for custom knives, and these are really a lot of handwork involved. He doesn't have access to a lot of mills and things like that, so there's a lot of handwork involved, a lot of time involved, which is the main thing you're paying with these custom knife makers, apart from the more expensive materials. But the time and expertise of these master craftsmen is the thing that you are paying those top dollars for. And I think here is absolutely justified because you can buy a lot of production knives that are much more expensive than this knife by Siemens Strickers, and I think he could easily charge quite a bit more for his work, and I'm very happy with the tour here. So check him out on Instagram as well if you're interested in his work. But as I said before, his stuff is also in very high demand and especially in very low supply. And then we have a couple of other custom knives. I'm not going to talk too much about them just because we don't want to get this to a 1 hour long video. But we have Casey Gray, which is a US knife maker that does also quite inexpensive work for the material that he uses, but still is a very great guy. He also did some pretty extensive warranty and spa work on this knife that I got from the secondary market without any issues. And that is certainly something that I would highly applaud on a maker that really stands behind his product. And that is also a thing that is a big thing with custom knives. It's a little bit like you have a knife from CRK. You can't have that for as long as you live because CRK is always going to honor that knife, and you can send it back for spa treatment. You can get a new blade and everything like that. The same is it with most good custom knife makers. They stand behind the product. You can send it in. Of course, you have to pay shipping, but then they will make the knife whole again. Here, it got shipped out to me from the seller with washers missing, heavy blade play, and everything. I shipped it back to Casey Gray. He sharpened it up, did the whole spa treatment, put in some new washers, and now it's pretty much perfect again. And I just paid for shipping. So that is certainly also a very nice thing about custom knives, that you really have something you can depend on and rely on, and that they stay very well behind their product, more than some production knife companies. And here, the last thing I want to show off is this Guy Pogetti Sanyo in absolutely gorgeous Tasmanian blackwood scales. And of course, that is certainly still an area where custom knife makers really shine, especially when you take a look at natural materials like horn, like stag, like different high-end woods, mammoth, things like that are mostly found on custom knives. And I, for my case, are very looking forward to getting knives with more unique, higher-end natural materials. I like some very gorgeous carbon fiber and some more materials on this end, of course, titanium and all those things. But I think these natural materials really add another level of uniqueness to these knives and really make them your own, because all these pieces of wood and stag are so different that there will not be one other knife that looks exactly like yours. And that is certainly also a big driver of this custom knife theme, is this uniqueness and exclusivity of the knives that you have. And that is certainly also a driver of this market. So I hope you could get a impression of what custom knives are for me, why I think that for specific people it can be very well worth it to go into this custom knife realm. But not all custom knives are better than production knives. Some of them are not as well built, have some lower end materials also, especially in blade steels. We have on the Zinkers, on the Lavial, we have steels that are not as high end as M390, 20CV and things like that. These are CPM 154 or RWL 34, which are good steels, but makers use them because they are easier to finish. They can put some higher end finishes on them more easily. And with that, you certainly sacrifice a little bit of edge retention and overall performance. But these knives are not meant to be your everyday hard user. They can be, but you have to sharpen them a little bit more. So that is certainly also a thing. If you want a knife that you can just abuse and use for days on end, and you really need the best steel out there, on most custom knives, you probably won't have as big of a selection of the latest super high-end powder steel, just because they are also working with some more limited tooling than, for example, a big company. So that is something I wanted to put out there as well. So overall, I'm a big fan of custom knives, but only certain custom knives. There are a bunch of custom knives that I don't really like, and that's really a personal preference. But overall, I think the custom knife world is a great thing to dabble in if you have the money set aside to do things like that. And I also think there are a lot of production knives that are really great. That's also why you have seen in my collection update, I still really have knives on either end of the spectrum, and I can see the great things on both ends of the spectrum in these knives. But I just wanted to talk a little bit about custom knives in general and show off my little collection that I have here at the moment. And I would love to hear what you have to say about custom knives. What are the pros? What are the cons? And what is your opinion? Are you into them or not? And why that is the case. So thank you for listening to me ramble here for 38 minutes. I hope you found it a little bit interesting. You had a little bit of eye candy to take a look at. And I really look forward to hearing from you in the comments below. Please follow me also on Instagram to see some more pictures of these and my other knives, and to stay up to date with what I'm reviewing at the moment. And also check out my Patreon account if you want to get early access to my videos. And if you want to get some new knives, check out White Mountain Knives to get 10% off your entire order by using my discount code 7ready. So thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.